Hello everyone, and welcome to Theme Park Coasting. And today we're over here at the most magical place on earth, Disneyland, California, to do a phenomenal vlog for you guys, as this is a park that Walt Disney went to start off all of his other amazing creations, such as Disney World, Disneyland Paris, and much, much more. So coming here, it just feels absolutely amazing. And someone who on this extra day, a couple days ago, was absolutely amazed with it is my dad. So are you looking forward to today?
Really looking forward to it, Tom. First full day in the park. We had a bit of a bonus day the other day, which is really lovely to do that. It's a proper day in the park. I'm about to go on the Matterhorn, but up to a few days ago, it would have been the oldest ride we've ever done, but we actually went on the something else in San Diego. So, yeah, look forward to today.
Yeah, it's cool, a big difference as well. But Adam, are you looking forward to today?
I'm really forward to today, especially going on the Matterhorn and Star Wars, Millennium Falcon.
Yeah.
And overall, it's
just amazing. Yeah, so Star Wars Land has opened now, so we're going to get in there and you're going to be able to see our reactions as we get in there. But now, we're going to head on to the Matterhorn bobsled.
Here we go.
We have completed Matterhorn and one of the best bobsleigh coasters, another coaster credit, so I really can't complain. But Adam, what do you think of
Dumbo?
Right.
Yeah, I mean, it's a sort of ride for me that it's good, just go on and say you've done it in a way, get a new coaster credit. It's not an amazing ride, but it's worth the experience if you want to go on it.
Yeah. And Dad, what do you think of the ride? And Mum?
It's a really good ride. Bit bumpy, but really good. I'm glad we've done sort of a real classic ride first thing this morning. It's nice.
Yeah, well, everyone says it's bumpy, but the truth is, it opened at 1959. I think that was the year the park opened as well. So
park opened 55.
55. So 4 years after the park opened, and really before any massive coasters came. So yeah, but compared to one of them like we did recently, we did the Big Dipper over at a park nearby San Diego. Finish checking out the vlog. The link will be up here. But compared to that, really. It's actually quite a smooth ride. But now we're going to head for the castle for the first ever time in one of our vlogs. So I'm very excited to do it and share it with you guys as well. But on the way, I'm going to ask Mummy, did you enjoy Matterhorn?
It wasn't the most comfortable of rides, but like you've all said, it's part of the history of the place, so
yeah,
fun.
Exactly. And this is a big part of the history of the castle. And we're entering through it in just a sec, so I'm going to keep talking to you along the way about it. And if you are new to this channel, make sure to like and subscribe, as well as comment down below, tell us what we can improve on, as well as others. But yeah, look how tiny it is.
Wow.
And actually, a little known fact for you guys is that this was met. Oh, well, there you go, thank you.
This is the front of the castle, and when they were, before they built it, they made a model. And then Walt was due to come into the room. Just when he came in the room, someone turned the castle around the other way to see what it looked like. As he did it, Walt walked into the room and said he liked it, but then he turned it around to see what it looked like. But that's how it ended up the wrong way around. So now this is now the back of the castle on the other side of the front.
There you go, I don't know if that for you guys. And I was going to say, like, one of the only facts I actually know around here is that. But down here, Macy USA, and the next one we're going to head towards is Star Wars Galaxy Edge with the rest of these, well, crowds around here. And as we enter Star Wars Land, probably the best themed area that I've ever been to, we're going to head over towards the ride, which all these people are actually heading to. And we'll be walking around pretty much to Frontierland entrance down Macy USA. And everyone has been going down this road, not one person has gone off. So, it's better than an hour queue, but better than the middle of the day sometimes when it gets to around 3 hours. However, I will be showing you a full tour, and then definitely don't go in there because they're guiding you the right way around there. But just the scenery is phenomenal, isn't it, Dad?
Amazing, absolutely amazing.
And it actually is going to be a new ride opening here very shortly, I think around September sometime, at the same time that the cable cars are opening at Disney World. There's going to be a new attraction coming over towards this land to kind of boost the theme up a little bit. which you can't really do anymore, but as long as being there's like all the restaurants in there, but they just haven't got as many rides as I'd have hoped to. And maybe I could add a little coaster in here, I don't know, but we got one of those like Star Tours, so let's go see how it is. See you in the queue.
Valuable merchandise across the galaxy. Pilots to navigate, engineers to operate the ship, and gunners to defend the shipments. And that is where you come in.
Here we go.
Intercepting a first order trade shipment of coaxial. Gunners, you clear the path. Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, harpoon that precious cargo. Move on, my friends. See you in the cockpit. Flight engineers, repair test. It goes as you happen. You'd better be faster when we get into real trouble. Pilot, hit the boosters. Now let's go get that coaxial. Right, pilot, make the jump to light speed. Woo! The
Now you kind of go in the vehicle, you get assigned roles, and then you board it and you've got to complete your roles. So I was the up and down pilot and the highest race speed. Adam was the left and right, that's why I was a little faster at times. And the accuracy was 53% thanks to you, Adam.
Yes.
And then, I'll say the bad thing, Adam.
Yeah, your name was.
And, yeah. It was a phenomenal attraction, and 100% go and ride it. We're definitely going in the morning, like we did open room, which is an hour for it. But just going to see new stuff, it's just like impeccable out there. Like, you can just queue up in here for so long. Then you've got this as well. I think the Star Wars in Florida is opening very shortly, like 2 years after this one. But wow, the Royal Millennium Falcon, it is phenomenal. Like, without a doubt, you have to ride this attraction. But now, we're going to head over to the next attraction, which I'm going to be sad to leave this area, but I'll shoot some more clips. But first, well, what did you think of it?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. One of the best moments I've ever been. Like, all the theming around the queue. But I didn't get bored, the queue was so good. Like, and then you got on like, with both pilots, you just like, half time you controlled it and you actually did control it, and half time you didn't. It was just overall an amazing ride.
Yeah. And finally, Dad, what did you think of the attraction?
Brilliant, really, really good. The theming throughout the ride was amazing and the ride itself was really good. Really interactive.
So now, let's go to Oz on attraction. and that ride is going to be Big Thunder Mountain. One of my favourite rides. We did it in Dark last time, so it's going to be the first day ride actually we've done on it. And it's my dad's favourite, obviously. But looking forward to it?
Oh yeah, I loved this one the other night. Really enjoyed it. So yeah, definitely looking forward to it.
Yeah. So let's go on the Big Thunder Mountain Railroad. Star Wars version actually, after completing Big Thunder Mountain and the Indiana Jones ride. Big Thunder Mountain, great as always, and yeah, really good. Mum, what do you think of it?
Really awesome.
Big Thunder Mountain, what do you think of it?
Oh, Big Thunder Mountain, yeah, I loved it again. It's good in the day, although I think I preferred it at night.
And Adam?
Yeah, quite
what do you think of Indiana Jones?
What?
What do you think of Indiana Jones?
Yeah, Indiana Jones is absolutely incredible. So I'm not going to spoil it, but go on Indiana.
It
is amazing.
Really, really, really. Yeah, really, really. And well, Phantom Ridge is an amazing hit. This it has to have reservations though to enter. But once you're in, definitely drink anything. But here's the menu if you want to know. And then I think it's the other side. But I was FaceTiming Jaden. Really, she just watched off the camera here and showing around. And he's a massive Star Wars fan. Just his face, he's going here. Everything is literally almost identical to his dad. Wow, it is phenomenal.
Get food in here as well, if you want
and there's food, yeah, that's it. But wow. We have only got half an hour in here to spend our time. We can leave an edge as we want. But wow. That is amazing. And just the scenery just blows your way in here. And Adam, what do you think of it? What do you think of it?
Yeah, it looks really, really good. Obviously, it's from the movies and stuff. But one thing is, you can't get, do you know the Coke bottles? You can't actually get them from this store here. So make sure to look around the Star Wars area if you want to find the Coke or Sprite or water.
We're now outside of Star Wars and Adam has brought his drinks. But I am joined with the one and only Jaden Austin, which is gonna look on the screen. Can't see you after in the shade. But yeah, what do you think of the land, Jaden? Hello. You're not with us at the moment, which is
yeah,
good.
Yeah, it looks really cool what I've seen.
Yeah.
Really like it.
It really is, isn't it?
I wish I was there.
I know, but you went to Chelmington today.
Yeah.
And what did you find out as well?
I found out that the pirate ship there is not opening in 2019. And also there's a new resin there.
Awesome. So I'll see you later, Jane. And remember, stay tuned to our channel so you can see when we're back in the UK, we can get some more vlogs with Jane in. But now we're going to head over towards Adventureland and going to compete for one and only Jungle Cruise. And that's actually the hotel that we're staying in. The hotel we're staying in, the Adventure Tower. So we have to obviously do a Jungle Cruise just to get along with the theme of the hotel room. And later on today we'll be heading up there before the evening show. And this vlog will have that in as well. So we'll have the Fantasmic as well as the fireworks and the Easter Chicken Club. So stay tuned to that because that'll be really awesome to see. But now we're just heading over towards Jungle Cruise and we've been on the one in Florida, very good, but I think this is a classic and you do pass actually the Indiana Jones ride, as I saw, but I'm still on this
part. I still love it, this shows you how drink you quick it. How quick you drink it because it's so good. Honestly, get one. So I just saw a bottle down there, I think it was like £4 for one of these. Pay £2, you get a nice four, nice souvenir.
Yeah, totally agree. And yes. We're now going to head over towards Jungle Cruise, but first, we're going to do Pirates of the Caribbean. Wish me luck, guys. Here we go on the adventure with Jack Sparrow.
I love it.
only two drops, so that's a bit disappointing. However, now we're out Tarzan's tree and I'm gonna go on the jungle cruise, like I said, there's two rides ago. But yeah, I've had an amazing little park so far, and we're still part of our massive, well, California road trip, so we've been to many places around the world. And if you are new here, please do like, subscribe, and my legs are killing me. I think I'm around 15,000 steps apart today, and many, many more to come in so much time. So yeah, what do you think of Pirates of the Caribbean?
Yeah, it was quite good. I still feel the price was quite more drops, but I think they had a lot of good drops at the start and then left to the end. Obviously it's the original one, so we've just got to deal with that, but
yeah, it really was. And everyone's ringing this bell, I've no idea why, but just ring a bell and just ring the bell. Here you go though, up Tarzan Street. We'll see you when we get down. We've done the jungle cruise and now we're over here on Toy Story Astro Blast. And what did you think of jungle cruise?
Yeah, I quite enjoyed jungle cruise. And it was a very good ride. And as well, there's like little hints and stuff when you're around. It's quite cool. And our driver was actually really nice. It's Matt, so it's really fun.
And Dad, what do you think of it?
Jungle cruise. Yeah, it's good. The guy did lots of cheesy gags, which is quite nice, as I imagined. I quite like the fact that they hadn't changed it too much, actually. So, you know, there's some incredible animatronics now at this park, but actually what they've done is kept that fairly original, which I thought was quite nice. So some of it was really good, some of it wasn't so, but it was original, which is nice to see.
Yeah.
As well, what I was just about to show you is, you have to ask at the till to get these things, but you can actually get the Jungle Cruise map. And if you look for it, that's the station, that's the Indiana Jones is there, and you've got the whole room of it, so it's really...
And now we're off in the theme park coaster for next season. Now, we're on a 5-minute queue for Astro Blast. And then, we did another, and another. That was... Well, it's Star Tours and we survived the journey. And good merch as well, actually, in there. Couple of good pin badges, only like $16 each. Ridiculous. Exactly, amazing. Not bad as an R2-D2, which is like 15 grand, I don't know, coin America, like $15,000.
And as well, there's a snug t-shirt that says Star Galaxy's Edge, and being 31st May is on for right. And that was only, it was a medium size. But that was only
$34
very fast.
Amazing, boys, absolutely amazing. But now we're heading over towards the one and only Submarine Voyage, one of the Disney classics.
Yeah.
Okay, and it's Finding Nemo as well. Well, yeah, it's Nemo, don't I go, so I'm not like that. So yeah, let's go and go on a Submarine Voyage. See what it's like, because I've never seen the big period before.
All in, full, steady as she goes. The coral reef.
I'm gonna explode all of it. words. None of words, remember the words.
Right then.
Well, we've just done the journey with Nemo and friends, and not very friendly actually, it's quite boring, but at the end it was a nice ride to sleep on, alright? And Adam, well, what did you think of Journey with Nemo?
Yeah, that was very dark, so you got very tired, but I luckily did fall asleep. I mean, it wasn't boring, they were very, very good, it just went on for quite a while, and yeah, like, I would do it, but I would still do like the classics first. I mean, though it's one of the original classics, it's still not great. It's the same thing.
Yeah, I think that's fair. I agree with that. However, I just don't want to do it. I know in the classic it wouldn't have had Nemo, so it's not really going to be a classic. However, you can tell there used to be a boat station there when people are fishing. And we're now going to head over towards Fantasia Land, or Fantasia Land, to some, well, actual classics.
It's like Small World that I think we're going to do next. I don't know, you can just say Small World is like one of the best rides, like it's so good, but it's just very classic. That is why it's good. If it wasn't classic, it wouldn't be good.
Yeah, I think one of the best builds for it as well was over at Disneyland Palace. However, this is on Farm Factory, looking really, really nice on the outside. And I think we're heading over towards a Small World, a magical world, over at the magicalest place on Earth. Yes, we're going here now, and to see you in it, a very small moment.
Welcome to It's a Small World.
Length ride with two stations, and both of them actually being outside, which is very unusual for an attraction. And another thing that was unusual is actually they got the characters from the movies inside, such as The Little Mermaid, they've got Cinderella, they've got loads more as well, including all of those inside it. But yeah, one of my favourite. I just think it lacks what I've seen it the others have, and as it was the original Walt Disney made. I think that kind of it wouldn't have much scenery because they haven't progressed so much in the thing. I don't know if it's going to be good or not, but I think it was good. I think it was a very good track, and I do like the white that's on this more than the pink one over at Disneyland Paris. But Dad, what did you think of A Small World?
It's obviously an original ride from here, so one that you had during the World's Fair, we got from Coca-Cola. But they've kind of kept it looking quite classic without being really done up, which is quite like actually. So, but yeah, it's good, really good, another good ride.
Yeah, I quite enjoyed it. I think it's longer than the other ones, but I mean, some of them was worse than the ones there. I think this one was better. Because as well, I think I had more reference to the movies that Pinocchio. I can't remember them, but it had loads of movies. But one movie they don't have anywhere, and I'm really surprised, I talked about earlier, is The Lion King. There's just nowhere, like they have an event on, but there's just nowhere.
Yeah, it's kind of relaxed, like, where's the problem with The Lion King and stuff? And right now, we're heading over towards Mickey's Toontown, another area which you can only enter over at Disney California. Disneyland California, I mean. Not Disney California Adventure, because that's where I went yesterday. I check out the vlog from Luther, and we will also be heading there in 2 days' time. But I don't know if the vlog will be uploaded. It will be uploaded within the next 2 weeks. But excited to be with Adam.
Yeah, I'm really excited. And as well, he's got my favourite coaster in the world. He's got another coaster, it's a kid coaster. Why not? And I think we'll come around to it now. It's just around that way. But it's like a red coaster. We'll show you over there.
Coaster Junior.
It's really good. No, he's not Coaster Junior. It's something like that. I forgot it's called.
Yeah, well, we're going to find out in a bit inside Mickey's Toontown. And that attraction is going to be Go Gadget Coaster. Wow, one of the coolest themed rides I think I've ever seen. Based on the TV series, which was around when my parents were younger, and then it got remade into an animation sort of series a bit later on. But Go Gadget has a pretty cool scenery as well towards the ride. I don't know what kind of layout it has, but it looks kind of the same as the little Dragon Ball coaster over at Disneyland Winter. So I am excited to ride the attraction. And Adam, excited?
Yeah, did you mention it's the same as Maximus?
No, it can't be.
Yeah, it's exactly the same. It's quite cool.
Oh, yeah, is it? It's just a bit bigger. It's just a bit. Like the Helix and everything's a bit bigger.
But
there's loads of them the same as that, and obviously Maximus at Creedy, my first ever roller coaster that I've done, so it's nice to bring up some of the layouts actually. And here we go, bro. On to Go Gadget Coaster. Love the handwork and stuff, it's really cool. I'm looking forward to it.
It's like a Goofy cartoon, isn't it?
It's like Goofy. It's gonna be more like Keystone Cops.
Heavy one here. Never seen this before in my life.
Yeah, it happens.
So, yeah, wow. Well, yeah.
Hang on. Your turn's up.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks.
Thank you. The weirdest thing ever.
On the wheel?
Nope.
They're on the wheel.
The front one. The front pacer?
Okay,
guys, we'll
power
up
and we'll send you through.
You're
rolling back.
Now we're going backwards, right?
Oh,
I thought you pushed us all the way around. No. I think you have to run up the hill afterwards. You look strong.
Second guy. Do it backwards, POV.
Yeah. Fun? Oh, yeah.
But it's pretty strong. It's just silly. Still, push in 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, we've made that now, Adam. We're still officially put on the coaster.
What?
We've made that now, we're still officially put on the coaster.
You've officially
been around.
You've never walked the world before.
Nope.
You must. Yeah, it's okay. It happens very rarely. Show them. What did you do? They were trying to push you backwards.
Yeah, I guess I'm pushing that.
They will probably push you up the lift or stop you.
Easy.
Yep, very good. The people in the staff are really nice, very nice. Very, very good. They pushed us up the lift hall.
Very quick, I would say.
Yes.
And here we go.
There they are.
The funniest breakdown that's ever happened to me. I thought I was going to evacuate it because I've never actually evacuated from a coaster, but you have.
Yeah, I am.
Lucky you. But honestly, I just couldn't stop laughing at that. Getting started and pushing, like, that's a pretty strong to do that. But Dad, you go ahead and explain what happened.
Yeah, I've never been on that leg before. I've been on a ride, been evacuated before it's broken down.
Space Mountain.
So that ride, I've been on a few actually broken down, but anyway, that ride, it broke down just as we left the station. So it hadn't reached the lift hill or any of the wheels that would pull it along. So they went and got a load of like maintenance guys and they physically pushed the train. They jumped on the track and pushed the train to the front of the car was up the first wheel so it could get momentum to go up the lift again. So a little bizarre, let's put it that way, but it was good.
Yeah, I thought it was good. It's what you love, it's cartoon spin. And that's how we're going now. But the ride itself was good. It's just a ride. But still, another coaster credit. But now here we go.
And as well, like, I think this network's really good. That's on the ride, the staff. Mega nice, people who pushed it, they had a laugh and everything. And that's what I like to see, you know?
Yeah, let's go, watch it happen.
Here you go! Time for a nice spin!
That's it, boys, what's that?
And we're now up in our hotel room. And I don't know if I did a view on Would You Rather, did I do one? Would You Rather review?
No, I don't think you did, no.
Well, it's an amazing ride, honestly. It's really, really good. But we just came up here just to have a quick, what is it called, Eat in the E-Ticket Lounge. And, well, because it's our last day as well over here. Well, at the hotel, of course, because we've only gone here for 2 days, if you are up to date about travelling. But, yeah, I'm going to miss it. I'm going to miss this hotel. It's very nice. And I am going to film a hotel vlog today, so stay tuned for when that comes out, if it's not already. But when it's just up in the room and waiting for my parents to comment down, and just looking at the view, like, look over here. Pool area. It's awesome slides. I love the slides. And then the sign. The only thing that's missing is a monorail station just over there. That would have been really awesome about one of those to get from the hotel over towards there. But I think one of us opening at 6, so that's we're going to be heading back down into the park.
I think it's 6 to 11 in the main park.
6 to 11, yeah.
But again, it does, the last train is 11, so make sure to get there by the closing dock. That is the last train, so you're going to have to walk. Not that far,
but. Yeah, of course, yeah. And it is at the moment 5:41, so we're going to have another 20 minutes at this hotel, and then we'll be down for magic in the park. So we'll see you down there. And where we actually started the vlog this morning, and actually going back on the ride this morning. But however, we are using one of our fast passes that we got on the pushy ride. If you started watching the vlog halfway through, you understand what I mean about that. But yeah, we're on the monorail, and you guys are sitting in the front. So what do you think of it?
On the monorail, yes. Yeah, so basically, we queued up for the monorail. We said, can we sit at the front? And the guy said, no, we're not doing that at the moment. And then when we got to the front of the line, I said, oh, any chance to get the front? And they said, oh yeah, well, there's only a couple of spaces left. But we, you know, Tom very kindly said we could go. So me and Adam went and sat at the front. Great experience. To be honest, not a great deal different to sitting anywhere else, but it's good to think you've done it, you know? So.
Yeah, well said. For me, it didn't really, well, it didn't matter to me a little bit. I wanted to do it and I wanted to finish for you guys, but I think it means more to them, so went over there. But now we're heading over towards the Matterhorn and I'm excited.
Yeah, I'm really excited for the Matterhorn. As we're on the monorail, we were going to film it for you, but then we didn't have any phones on us, I think. But yeah, the front is good. The problem is, there's two people, and we got there, and there was four of us sitting in the car. A bit confusing, but yeah, it was actually quite good. The Matterhorn, it is like classic of it. It is so, so good. And like the queue's never ages for it. And obviously, this was our first ever ride today. That was quite cool. And yeah, it's an amazing ride.
Yeah, and thing is though, no phones. One tip for you guys, always bring phones to the theme park, because not only do you get Instagram, but also they have got the Disneyland app, which allows you to know the queue time, where you are, and much, much more. But now, I know where we are. We're here, and we're going to be heading on to that. However, the Matterhorn doesn't want us to ride, and the Yeti has defeated us, as it has not opened the other side due to Yeti damage apparently. It's just not working, but hopefully when we return, actually tomorrow we decided, instead of going for an adventure, we'll hopefully be able to do the other side and get another credit on there. But without getting the credit, there's no point really doing it again. And I'd much rather do other rides, more intense rides, more thrilling rides, such as Alice in Wonderland, the Teacups, and Storybook Land. Wish me luck.
Look into the white rabbit. Oh, see for yourself.
Oh, Mr. Rabbit, wait, please.
It went this way. No, that way.
Oh, they're weeds. Now, this is curious.
Rule 42, the queen always wins.
So, we didn't just go on Alice in Wonderland, we went on the roof of a ride, and that was weird. It wasn't the greatest theme, but I think I showed you that bit. But still, another little aspect of a ride I've never done before. And, well, Mum, you're a big Alice in Wonderland fan. What did you think of it?
I thought it was a really good ride, but like Dad said, it was a bit strange when we came outside on the roof for that little while. But yeah, loved it. We thought it was really good.
Yeah, it was a ride, like I said, around 3 minutes I think it was, so nice little ride. But now we're going to carry on our storybook adventure and actually head on the authentic, magical and amazing ride. But first, Adam wants to say something very important to you guys.
Yeah, about that ride, is this what you're saying about?
Yeah.
Yeah, about this ride, it's basically, it was an okay ride. It's a bit weird though, because at the top on the roof, all you do is that. It just gets a bit repetitive. But the indoor sections are really nice and all that, but it's just the outdoor is.
Yeah, well, I hope this one's better. Here we go.
Yeah, I hope
so. Ferry starts through the jaws of Monstro the Whale. The same one that swallowed Pinocchio. We're really being transported into a magical place called Storybook Land. Places like the Cave of Wonders. Legend has it, whoever sets the genie free will be granted 3 wishes. So let's go ahead and make a wish and see if it comes true. Back into the pumpkin, and you can still see it up on that bridge.
As we finish in Fairy Tale Land, we are now outside of one of the most famous horses in the whole of Disney history. Yes, this is Jingles, the horse when Walt Disney was trying to persuade Julie Andrews, So, you go explain.
So, it's the horse that they dedicated to Julie Andrews because she did so much for Disney movies. She's a Disney ambassador, so.
And she was the one who were like, stuff like, forgot the name, Snow White, the first of the Disney movies.
Not Snow White. Mary Poppins.
That was it. I got to see, I'm getting tired now. It's late. And many more like that, so that was the horse, the specialist one in the park.
Yeah. And as well, if you know the horse, on the back of the horse, it's very small though, but it has got a little umbrella, a symbol of Mary Poppins. So if you see that umbrella, it's very small though, so I don't think you would see it. If you do, you see it. It's so cool,
no,
they had one of these in Florida.
There's no chance of it. And Paris, they've got kind of the whole fancy land in everywhere. It's all basically the same. However, the other lands were mixed up a little bit. But now, we're going to go on a journey. Or maybe something else.
What are we doing?
I think we're going to do Snow White.
Yeah, where
is Snow White? Snow White's Gay Adventure. I'll tell you quite a funny story after Snow White.
Magic mirror on the wall.
With this disguise, I fooled them all.
That was more anything but Snow White, but there was the Seven Dwarfs. Honestly, it's pretty much the weirdest ride I think I've ever been on. I think that's weird, going around in circles over and over again. It's you were sitting in your car, good start, the witch turns on, and then the witch gave Snow White the apple. Well, not Snow White, she was just standing on the stairs in front of the dwarf, and then they went through another door and said they would have had it ever after. Huh? Like, what was the rest of the story? What was that prince? What about even Snow White? She wasn't even here. Oh, really, really odd. But Dad, what did you think of it?
Of what? Snow White?
Yeah.
Weird, actually. It just kind of seemed to finish halfway through the story. It was a bit odd.
And then just that there is Dumbo, but only one I think that has a single Dumbo car, because most of them have two different track systems, two different ride systems. That's actually the only one with one. And really magical to be here, but a more magical thing, well, probably not magical, but a very magical thing for me is if you subscribe to the channel, because that means I can do more videos and try and things like this way more often. But now, we're going to head over towards our next attraction, as it is now dark and I'm very excited to do much much more. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-day. This could be our lot of fun of a day. Well, actually no, because we're going to go to some show, he's going to go and watch. But still, I just want to run. It just sounds good. Anyway, we're now going into Critter Country and to board the Zippity-Slide in the Wilderness, which I forgot the name, that's why I'm doing that. We're now going to board Splash Mountain, one of my favourite water rides, actually in California as well as in Florida, honestly. But you've got to know in Paris, guys, because Paris is our home park, only around 4 hours away. So if any Americans watching this will be like, wow, why didn't you go every day? But no, it's a long way for us British people. But I just love the Splash Mountain rides, honestly, it's just great fun. And it feels different look here, I don't know why. Well, it went less last time, but for the last time I was the route. Anyway. And in Florida as well, it went on the back, so it's a bit different. But wow, I'm looking forward to this jetty still. Unfortunately though, I will not be filming on this attraction because I want to enjoy it, because I've got a canvas in front of my face. It kind of ruins it a little bit. So I'm going to enjoy this attraction, and then after we're going to go into e-ticket suites to then show you inside. Wow. One of the best areas to watch the fireworks from. Wow, that is better than I remember. No, I don't know whether it's because I was on the front row, because Alan never lets me go there, or whether it's because, well, first time today, because I'm sitting on the monorail at the front, they let you sit on my front at the front, so I'm happy about that. I'm not back on. I'm heading now, though. We're heading over to my but heading over to the Splash Mountain at the front, which I'm happy about. But I just love the ride. It's got like 5 drops in it. One of my favourite, well, my favourite has to be, not the big one actually, it's the one where you go down and then you go on a track and go up again and then drop down one more time in the middle. And it was absolutely awesome. Walk on. Better move, use the emergency stop button, however, because Adam wanted to switch seats.
Yes, that was not my fault.
It was your fault.
No, it was just an emergency stop button. He just stopped it.
Yeah. They stopped it, and it was
not an emergency.
And it was an emergency because the car was moving while Adam was trying to switch seats.
No, it was normal.
Anyway, that doesn't matter. Okay. But anyway, now we're going to be heading over towards Matterhorn. The way to Matterhorn, there's one little problem that's blocking our path, and that's actually a very colourful problem. And we are in a rush to see the fireworks as well, so hope this goes quick.
The slopes of the Matterhorn. Before boarding,
Matterhorn is amazing, and I never know if it's Leghorn. I swear on the front, you get more Leghorn, I don't know. But did you get more Leghorn on the front?
Well, I was right at the front, I think. It was the first time I think it was right at the front, but that's great. Doing it in the dark as well is really good, because you get just the views across the park, fantastic. Everything lit up, different colours, it's amazing.
Yeah, there was
a light parade at the same time as well. Wow.
Yeah, well, I said, still massive classic as well. Like, you can't just do that in the Matterhorn. Like, if I come to a theme park, if you go into a theme park, I don't want to come in here first before you do any upgrades, because you do all the classics, and then you, I know, yes, people go smaller, but you respect all the other rides as well. After you do this one, and you go to like Disney World, Paris, it's like you respect all of that, because of it all being like that. However, we're now going into Tomorrowland, going to be up with Adam, who's doing Space Mountain, and then head back to the E-Club, so I'll see you guys watch the fireworks on the car.
All those years outside the camp, all
There we go, the E Club over in the Disneyland Hotel. And now we're downtown. Oh, I think that's Mississippi. It's Disney. No, it is downtown Disney. I get confused sometimes, guys, honestly. I'm overdoing stuff so many times, different Disneys. I just get confused. But now we're going to head back on the monorail over towards Magic Kingdom. Again, I got it wrong again. It is Disneyland Park. And it feels weird to say that. Because Disneyland Paris says it, and like, yeah, whatever. But this is really Disneyland Park. And like, I will go there. But now, let's go on the monorail. But the monorail wasn't working, so we could not do that. However, we're going to quickly go and jump on Big Thunder Mountain. We're now in the park before we get in to the one and only Fantastic or Magic or something like that. Well, we'll work out in a bit and I'll tell you what. But yeah, we're going to quickly go and run over to Big Thunder Mountain, do it in the dark, love that attraction, let's go. Well, one of the most fantastic Disney shows of all time. And Adam, well, what did you think of it?
No, I really, really enjoyed Fantasmic. Princess of Florida one, the April Maze of Florida one has a proper stadium, this doesn't. But I did enjoy it. And in the Florida one, Dopey obviously fell off the boat that was like on the news and everything. But it was still an amazing show, still went really, really high.
Yeah, like I said, really, really great. And I love the Pirates of the Caribbean, that's one of my favourite scenes. So unique, and actually, I don't know if you've ever seen it in the news, but the time that Dopey fell off a boat, I've just seen it on YouTube, I don't know if you've seen it. We were actually in that stadium, and I actually managed to get some footage of it happening. Not the greatest enough to send it off and put it on a YouTube video, but still, it was some really good footage of it, actually. And just watching that just reminded me back of that moment in 2016, I must be. Don't be mistaken, but yeah. Let's not go over to Pirates of the Caribbean after that. Well, pretty amazing stunt that Jeff Ryder did on that.
Thank you.
second time and now all part of the cabby. And today has never actually felt so long in my life. Literally, it is exactly like 11:15. And I forgot to get my watch on today, as we're not going to do any filming actually off. But 11:15? 11:20. Definitely, yeah, we've been filming since like 8 o'clock this morning, so shattered actually, guys. I really am. But we're still going to be filming watch for you, getting some more footage in before we do leave the park. However, it is officially closed, so make sure to stay tuned as we sum up this vlog very shortly. However, it's been a really good day today, and this is our first full day actually in the kingdom itself. But we still have many stuff to do, including the train, one of the most iconic Disney things in the world. And we're really looking forward to riding that. That'll be done tomorrow. So if you're staying to tomorrow's vlog, we'll be going riding the train right there, as well as Tom Sawyer Island. Critter Country will be doing as well, which is Duck Mountain. Haunted Mansion is closed, unfortunately. So if you do want to see that, check out our vlog before. And then what's else on that board? Duck Mountain, yeah, I love that ride, as you've already noticed. But yeah, it's good. It's a good part, very good part. Favourite part. Yeah, Disney is done. But now, like I said 100 times, we're going to be exiting the park, but I'll probably catch up with you a bit later on the way, before I'm showing you some more clips, but I'll have to end the vlog inside our hotel room for our last night. But don't leave yet, guys, because we still have another 2 more vlogs coming off from our California road trip, and probably even more. And then the day comes to an end, and I am absolutely shattered. I can't tell you how tired I am. It is actually at the moment, 11:58, so it's 2 minutes to midnight, and I will be filming the countdown towards midnight over at Disneyland, California. And Adam, how have you enjoyed today?
Yes, I have really, really enjoyed my day today. It's been absolutely incredible. And we've gone past Cadbury, and we're really happy we got on that one today. We've gone on a lot more than I expected, and we did break down a bit on the Mickey Toontown's coaster. That was really cool. And there's precious and all, that was a really funny moment. But then there's just been that every minute has been really, really fun. And we've been in the hotel, out the hotel, but we still had like a full day in the park. That was really, really good. And
Yeah, it has honestly been absolutely amazing. And Mum and Dad, did you enjoy today?
Had an absolutely amazing
really
day.
Good day.
We're all exhausted, but it's been brilliant. Really, really good. And we've done so much.
Yeah, honestly, quite so amazing it is. And
this
then,
is just today. Those are the fast passes we've used. That's not even much.
Amazing, absolutely amazing. And literally, I'm going to get the time up for you. I try and find this clock so I can actually do it. Yeah, exactly. It's been an absolutely amazing day, I can't tell you. I have gone, but I did love when we broke down over there. That was just honestly so funny, just sitting there and watching the breakdown. And I'm trying to find like an online clock just to get the countdown. About, gotta be quick. But yeah, it's been great, I like you saying this, but, oh, there you go. 00:00. It is midnight, and this is our theme park hosting. And yeah, this is Disneyland Hotel. And the end of our vlog over here today at Disneyland, California. I hope you enjoyed. Goodbye. It's been amazing, honestly. My name is Tom Deck from Theme Park Hosting, and see you soon.